But still, there are major questions that revolve around the punk movement. First of all, is punk a product of the voracious mass media?
I think punk was there long before the media found it. Matter of fact, the media paid catch-up ball, especially in New York, and in Toronto to some degree. And I think it's a legitimate musical force. It's a legitimate entity, whatever it is. And I think the media has, in the most superficial way, tried to trendset with it. But in a more serious way, try to explore it, because punk does offer something very meaty to chew on. It offers a real rejection of a lot of sort of soft culture around now. And nothing softer than what was once rock and roll culture.
I'm tough. Just, that doesn't mean like strong and stuff, but I'm tough from like having to live on my own for a few years, you know, when I wasn't like ready for it, and not even getting welfare, not eligible for fucking welfare. The whole love thing was just marketed to us from all the major companies. And the same thing is happening already with the punk scene. All the major department stores are going to be marketing their own brand of punk clothes. All the fashion designers are scratching their heads, wondering what to sell this new generation. And already you can buy punk t-shirts for $600 in New York City with rips and slashes in them, no different than you could do yourself. And it's just, it's merchandising, it's the whole thing. I've seen possibilities. Crazy possibilities. People want to get excited. I mean, if you want to hear good music, you can sit at home and play it on your stereo, and it'll be 50 times better than it will be at, you know, any of the major halls where you go and see concerts. If you go see a live show, the whole point is being excited, getting off on the scene. And I think that's what the kids are trying to do. They're trying to make it exciting, and I think it will work.
The punks have no hesitation wanting to be heroes. I mean, there's none of this sort of, oh gosh, gee whiz, I sort of fell into my last million record. They're after it. They're trying to sell it as hard as they can. And so you find so many bands recording so many awful records so early in their careers just because of it. They just want to get it out quickly.
Well, I mean, for one thing, I want to be an anti-star. I want to destroy that term. But I know I'll be famous. Like, I believe that I'll be known everywhere.
But what the punks are doing is rejecting sort of this, the folksy, earthy, extension of the 60s that really does dominate rock culture right now, Fleetwood Macs and all those people. They're sort of saying, listen, come on, you guys really want to sell main records, you guys really want to be famous, you want to have girls around or guys around, whatever it is, you really want that, don't you? So the punks are saying that, and they're embedding it right in their music.
And as far as the music is concerned,
I don't know, I think it's sort of like garbage.
I think you can look for a lot of releases probably between now and Christmas. There's not too many bands that I can think of that have either not put out a record on their own or haven't been picked up by a label.
What is going to happen is that a lot of people are not buying punk because of the name and because of its image. They're going to start hearing some of the bands, some of the better bands. They're going to suddenly realize it's just basic rock and roll, played with a little bit more energy than most rock and roll. They're going to like its rawness and its roughness and its lack of studio $100,000 qualities. They're going to like that kind of thing. And there's going to be a sizable group, I would expect, within the next year buying it. Now, I don't think this is going to be a wave that's going to Beatleize, in a sense, rock and roll. What it's going to do is be one of its many components, like disco or like whatever else. I mean, it's going to be like a punk following. I mean, if in a year a punk band can play a Carnegie Hall or a Massey Hall, it'll have done a lot, done a long way.